Hello friends and welcome to Geeks for Geeks. In this tutorial, we are going to cover open addressing, which is one of a collision resolving technique in hashing. Before we begin with this tutorial, we would strongly advise you to be aware of these following terms. We have covered all these topics in our previous videos on hashing. So you may pause this one and have a look at them first. So let's begin with open addressing. Open addressing is a collision resolving technique in hashing. And the special thing about it is that all the keys are stored in hash table itself. Here, the size of table has to be greater than or equal to the number of keys that need to be hashed. The hash function that we use specify an order of slots to probe instead of giving just a single slot. Now, we have few techniques of probing. They are linear probing, quadratic probing, and double hashing. We will see all of them in detail and we will study them for the following operations. The operations are insert, search, and delete. So let's start with linear probing. In linear probing, we linearly probe for next slot. The increment of slot after every try is generally 1. The basic function h of I is some hash function hash of x plus iteration sequence I modulo hash table size. This will give the slot to probe. As an example, consider these. First, we calculate h naught. If it is empty, we insert our key, else if full, we calculate h1. H1 is again hash of x plus 1 modulus hash table size. This will in most cases give the immediate next slot. If it is full, we calculate h2 and so on. So far we have seen the mathematical aspect of probing. Let's also have some hands-on through an example. Consider the following keys on which we need to perform some operations using linear probing. Let's also have our hash table. Notice that our hash table has 11 slots, which is greater than our number of keys, which are 4. Now, for each slot, we have defined 3 states. A slot is either empty, as we can see here initially, a slot can be occupied, and a slot can have a deleted element. These states are necessary for our search operation, as we will see ahead. So let's start with inserting our keys. H0 is 7 modulo 11, which is 7. We insert this key on index 7. Note how the color representing state of the slot has changed to occupied. Next, we insert 36. Here h0 is 3, so we insert the key at index 3. Next, we insert 18. We calculate h0, which comes out to be 7. Now collision occurs as our 7th index is already taken. So what we do is we calculate h1. h1 comes out to be 8. Since index 8 is empty, we put key 18 there. Next, we insert 62. h0 is 7. which is occupied, so a case of collision. We therefore calculate H1, which is 8, and also occupied. We then calculate H2. It comes out to be 9. Since 9 is empty, we can put 62 there. We are done with inserting keys, and therefore we can say that the basic idea is to keep probing until an empty slot is found. Once an empty slot is found, insert key there. Now we see search operation. Let's say we want to search key 18. The idea for search is keep probing until slot's key doesn't become equal to key being searched or an empty slot is reached. We calculate H0. Key at H0 is not equal to 18, and also the slot is not empty, so we calculate H1. Key at H1 equals to 18, so we break as we have found our element. Next, we see the delete operation. This operation is interesting, as if we simply delete a key, then search may fail. So if we have to delete key 18, its slot should be marked as deleted and not empty. So here we make a note that we can insert a key at a slot with deleted state, but our search operation should not stop on this slot. Next, we move on quadratic probing. The basic difference is that here the increment is quadratic. Instead of I, we have I square. Notice the increment is 0, 1, 4, 9, and so on. Let's again see it with the same example. We insert key 7. Since H0 is empty, we insert it. Next, we insert 36. H0 is 3 and index 3 is empty, so we insert it. Next, we insert 18. H0 is 7 and 7 is already occupied. Since a collision has occurred, we calculate H1. H1 comes out to be 8. Since it is empty, we insert 18 at index 8. Next, we insert 62. H0 is 7, which is occupied. Since a collision has occurred, we calculate H1. H1 is 8, which is again occupied. We therefore calculate H2. H2 comes out to be 0. Since slot with index 0 is empty, we insert 62 there. With this, we have inserted all the keys. Next, search and delete operations uses the same idea as we have done in linear probing, so we skip them. Let's see another technique, which is also known as double hashing. In double hashing, we use another hash function, and the general function is first hash function plus I into second hash function modulo table size. The only difference with previous method is that here we are using two hash functions instead of one. However, the other idea for insert, search, and delete operation remains the same. Now, let's compare the three methods that we have learned so far. The first method was linear probing. It is easy to implement, has the best cache performance, and suffers from clustering. That is, many consecutive elements form groups and It starts taking time to find a free slot or to search an element. The next method was quadratic probing. It has average cache performance, and in this, clustering also occurs in a very less amount. Last method was double hashing. It has worse cache performance. There is no clustering of keys in this method, and it also involves more computation time. Let's finally look at the complexity of open addressing. For this, we define load factor alpha, which is n by m. M are the number of slots in our hash table, and n are the number of keys that need to be inserted in our table. So the worst case complexity comes out to be big O of 1 by 1 minus alpha, which is basically an upper bound on the expected number of trials required for a success. With this, we come to an end of this tutorial. If you have any doubts or suggestion, please leave them in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.